Mike Schmitz. We're here with Paul Lebois. We're out in Santa Barbara, California. I just finished up a day of workouts here, you know, on the court, P3. Paul, we've interviewed you, it seems like everywhere else in the world, and you know, seeing you out in Italy, but now we're here in the States, you know, talking for the first time. When did you get out here? What has the process kind of, you know, been like since you've been here?
Everything is good. I fly from Rome last Friday for 25. So from LA and then LA here to start in training, so practice here in between and then on the court too. So everything's going good. I'm very happy to be here.
Yeah, what's it been like? You're with some guys who, you know, were big time college basketball players, and you know, Duke, Washington, Minnesota, projected first round picks. A trainer who's, you know, one of the best in the business in Ross. What is kind of the feeling being around with these type of guys?
Yeah, in the beginning it was a little bit like different, because we didn't know each other, and then you're in the house, like you start to speak a little bit, you change other culture. Yeah, now it's like you're a friend now, like you can speak. They are very funny, and then they help me with English. Then they start to learn something in Italian or French too. So it's very cool. I'm happy too to work with Russ. Individual training, he teach me the very important things, some different move, you know, to how move my feet, because it's a little bit different than Europe here, how attack the rim, you know, how you can position, how we can stay on the different parts in the of the floor. So yeah, these kind of things.
Yeah, for sure. You can see the progress you've made even since coming here. What are some of the main things you're trying to focus on while you're out here?
The main thing I'm focusing my bowling link, and then my shooting. You know, I want to be more consistent during this process. Yeah.
And what have you been up to before you came out here? So, you know, the season ended, and then where you've been in Italy, what have you been up to?
Yeah, the first time I went in Pesaro when the coronavirus started, and then I did 1 month and a half there, and then I drive to Roma when I stayed in Roma until final April, and until now when I flew from LA. So I've been working there all the summer. In Stella Azzurra, yeah, with my last teammate, with Germano, with the staff of Stella Azzurra, to prepare myself the best I can there.
Yeah, was it difficult for you? Because, you know, I know most of your family is still in Cameroon, and there's a pandemic going on, and Italy was very, you know, hit very hard and shut down. Was it difficult to kind of go through that? Like, were there times you were feeling alone, or?
Yeah, it was very difficult also because I lost my dad during this that period, so it was very hard for me staying like far at home, and then leave that moment alone, also because I'm the last of my family, so they was very preoccupied about me, about my situation. And then Stella Azzurra, like it's like my family there. They give me a lot of support about this.
And I mean, I think anyone who sees you play, you know, your body, your length, really, really stands out. You know, it's one of the best in the draft. What do you think it is that you can kind of bring, you know, to an NBA team?
For sure, my physicality, my athleticism, and then my, you know, my defense too. You know, that's the best thing. I did now the best thing I show during the right here in Pesaro, you know, in this first league, you know, I was very good. My physicality helped me very a lot to you know, to play and then help my team. So that's the thing I can bring for sure.
What type of season do you think you had with Pesaro?
Yeah, I had a pretty good season. Like I was a rookie there, and then playing like a lot of match in starting five. You know, win the respect of my coach with my teammates. That's means very. It's very important for me, you know. And then coming from Division 2 and Division 1, and then play a lot of games, stay a lot of, spend a lot of the minutes on the court was very important for me for this draft, you know.
So what's the plan, I guess, moving forward, right? You're hoping to stay in the draft and you know, be in the States, or what's your goal?
I hope I'm going to stay in the draft and stay in the set. Yeah, that's my plan.
Yeah. And what's I guess, what are you looking for in a situation? You know, someone who will develop you or, you know, give you minutes. What are you looking for, I guess, at the next level?
You're going to see that depend of a lot of things, you know. They depend on who going to ask me, the program I'm going to have, and then a lot of things I'm going to speak with my agent too. So this is not the thing I can decide or should answer now.
And have you been watching the NBA, you know, playoffs and the finals, and anything that you've seen that kind of stands out to you that maybe, you know, relates back to your game?
Yeah, the, you know, how Miami did, the thing Miami did during this playoff, how they play together, how the physicality they put, like Jimmy Butler, his mentality, how they put, like, the defense they put, you know, you can see that that's very, like, a family team.
Yeah, for sure, no question. And you definitely have the physical profile of a lot of those guys, you know, whether it's Jay Crowder or, you know, Bam or all those guys. So, well, Paul, I'm glad you made it out here, and best of luck throughout the rest of the process.
Thank you, man.